Everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 26 for our valuable viewers. So in today's course coverage, we will again move to chapter number 5, Isothermal Reactor Design, and accordingly we will see the difference between the liquid and the gas phase reactions, the pressure drop and its linkage with the rate law, and finally the isothermal design algorithm. And as you know that we are covering this topic from the building block number 4, which is related to the isothermal design, an important part which is based on stoichiometry, rate laws and mole balance. Once we talk about the liquid phase reactions, we see that the concentration of the reactants has a minimal or a negligible effect with relatively large changes in the total pressure. So accordingly, once we are sizing the systems which include the liquid phase, or once we are designing a reactor where liquid phase system is involved, we can simply ignore the effect of pressure drop on the rate of reaction. But once we are talking about the gas phase reaction, the concentration of the reacting species is proportional to the total pressure. So accordingly, we must or we always have to take the effect of pressure drop while we are making any calculations related to the design. Because if we do not take the pressure drop considerations accordingly, we are moving towards the failure of the reactor operation. As you can see that therefore proper accounting for the effects of pressure drop on the reaction system can be a key factor in the success or failure of the reactor operation. And accordingly, once we have a system where catalysts are involved, or especially in case of packed bed reactors, we have to specially consider that aspect. So that is the difference between the liquid as gas phase reactions once we are talking about the pressure drop. That in case of liquid phase system, we can simply ignore that aspect. But in gas phase reaction, we cannot ignore. We have to definitely take that concept inside the algorithm. Otherwise, our reactor operation can be failed. So starting with pressure drop and its significance and accordingly linkage with the rate law, if you remember our previous equation, that C of I is equal to C a naught theta I plus VI x over 1 plus epsilon x P over P naught T over T naught. These are the temperatures, initial and final. Initial and final pressure, x is the conversion, epsilon sigma into Y naught, V of I is the stoichiometric coefficient, theta I is equal to flow or mole of that component divided by the limiting reactant, and C naught is the initial concentration of limiting reactant, and C of I corresponds to the species. So as you can see, epsilon is equal to Y naught sigma, theta I is equal to Fi naught over Fa naught, and Vi is the stoichiometric coefficient. Now what is our task, or what we have to derive? Determine the pressure ratio P over P naught as a function of the PFR reactor volume or PBR catalyst weight to account for the pressure drop for the gas phase reactions, obviously. Then we can combine the concentration, rate law and design equation. And if you remember our previous lecture where we had said that once there is no pressure drop, we will consider the integral form of equation. But once there is a pressure drop or a heat exchange, we will consider the differential form of equation. So that is written over here as well. So once we move to the isothermal design algorithm, the first two steps, let's assume a second order reaction that 2 moles of A goes to B plus C in an irreversible manner. Accordingly, the mole balance, we will take the differential form of equation Fa naught dx over dw is equal to minus Ra prime. If you remember our initial lectures, that for plug flow reactor, we will take minus Ra, while for packed bed reactor, it will be minus Ra prime. The units of volume are replaced by the weight of catalyst in this. As you can see, that units of minus Ra prime are moles per gram of catalyst per minute. And accordingly, rate law is minus Ra prime is equal to KCA square. Then going to the stoichiometry, that C of A is equal to FA over V. Now that F of A is equal to FA naught into 1 minus X, and V is equal to V naught 1 plus epsilon X P naught over P T over T naught. Previously, we have said it is an isothermal system, so T over T naught is cancelled out, and we have said no pressure drop, so P naught over P is cancelled out. But now, since we are assuming that there is a pressure drop in the system, we cannot simply say P naught is P and cancel it out. We have to definitely consider it. And if we do not consider it, after reading this topic today, then there is a mistake in the system. So Fa naught over V naught is Ca naught, 1 minus x over 1 plus epsilon x, P over P naught, T naught over T. So once we combine, minus Ra is equal to K Ca square, so that Ca term, which Ca is equal to this one, whole square. And for isothermal operation, we say T is equal to T naught. So this is cancelled out. So what we get, minus Ra prime is Fa naught dx over dw, that is equal to K part will remain. So accordingly, Ca naught, 1 minus x over 1 plus epsilon x whole square, P over P naught whole square. So that is the overall representation of this equation. And as you can see, minus Ra prime is equal to Fa naught dx over dw. Then evaluating, we write the same equation again, that Fa naught dx over dw is equal to K, whole bracket Ca naught 1 minus x over 1 plus epsilon x square, P over P naught whole square. Accordingly, we know that Fa naught is equal to V naught Ca naught. So that Ca naught, one part of Ca naught is cancelled out. If you see, we place V naught Ca naught over here, Ca naught is cancelled out with this Ca naught, but it's in square, so accordingly it will come out. But it will become K Ca naught over V naught. In bracket, it will be 1 minus x over 1 plus epsilon x whole square, P over P naught whole square. And on the left side, it is dx over dw. So we can say that this dx over dw is a function of x and p, because k is constant term, Ca naught is a constant term, V naught, which is volumetric flow rate, again it's a constant term, this epsilon, again it will be a constant term. So what are the variables in the system? Accordingly, x and p. So we said that this differential of x with respect to the differential of weight of catalyst is a function of conversion and pressure. And our next task related to it, which we will be covering in our next lecture, is to relate the pressure drop to the catalyst weight in order to determine conversion as a function of catalyst weight. So please make sure that after listening to this lecture, you follow the next lecture, because these two lectures are interlinked. And to avoid making video too bulky, I have split that lecture into two parts. So I hope you have understood all the aspects related to this chapter. If you have any queries, feedback, suggestion, please provide it in the comment box and I will be happy to answer it. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.